Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Welcome to Latvenergo Investor Conference webinar about financial results of 3 months, 2016. Today we are hosted by Latvenergo CFO Guntars Balčiūns. Before I give the floor to Mr. Balčiūns, a short reminder about the agenda of the webinar. Firstly, we will have a presentation about Latvenergo Group activities and financials in the first 3 months of 2016. Afterwards, we will proceed with a questions and answers session. We have already received some questions. If you would also like to use the unique chance to ask a question directly to the CFO of Latvenergo, please use the question box on the right side of your screen. All questions will be addressed after the presentation. Mr. Balčiūns, I invite you to start the presentation.
Thank you. Good afternoon, investors and stakeholders. It's my pleasure to welcome you to Latvenergo webinar. My name is Guntars Balčiūns. I'm CFO of Latvenergo. During the webinar, I will present Latvenergo Group interim results for the first quarter 2016. So there is agenda for the presentation. I will start with a brief introduction about Latvenergo Group, then I will continue with financial results and current issues. And at the end of the presentation, there will be question and answer session. Latvenergo is vertically integrated utility that operates in all three Baltic countries and is wholly owned by Republic of Latvia. Company's credit rating is Baa2 with stable outlook. Credit rating was upgraded by Moody's Rating Agency at the beginning of 2015. Our key generation assets are combined heat power plants and hydropower plants. As well, we own distribution and transmission assets. As electricity supplier, we hold approximately one-third of the market in the Baltics, and two-thirds of our sales are in Latvia, and approximately one-third of our sales are in neighbor countries, Lithuania and Estonia. Our operations are organized in three operating segments: generation and supply, distribution and transmission assets. Before I start with financial results, I would like to give a short update on market factors that have affected our business performance. In first quarter 2016, electricity spot price in Nordics and Baltics continued to decrease. The electricity price in Finnish bidding area diminished by 6%, reaching 30.3 euros per megawatt hour. However, the average electricity spot price in Latvia and Estonia decreased by 2% and reached 36.5 euros per megawatt hour in Latvia and 31.8 euro per megawatt hour in Estonia. The electricity price decrease was mainly affected by higher fuel of the Nordic hydro reservoirs, which in turn fostered also larger hydro power generation. Also, coal prices contributed to the reduction in electricity price, and we see that the coal price in the world market decreased by some 25%. The decline in electricity price in Latvia and Lithuania was also driven by lower natural gas price in Latvia. The gas price in Latvia was by 25.4% lower than the last year. This facilitating higher electricity output at Riga CHPs. As well, electricity generation at CHPs limited the electricity price level during the peak hours in the region. The gas tariff continues to decrease, as you see in the graph, and in the June, the gas tariff in Latvia for industrial customers reached the lowest level in 9-year period. Our cogeneration plants. Additionally, at the beginning, of the shortage of internet connecting area comparing to Finland and Estonia. Let me continue with Latvenergo Group financial results for the first quarter, and in Q1, Latvenergo Group revenues reached 264 million euros. That is increased by some 2% comparing to last year. Also, Latvenergo EBITDA increased and in Q1 reached 100 million euros. That is increased by some 6%. The results were positively impacted mainly by lower price of natural gas. And as I already mentioned, the natural gas price was by some 24% lower than last year. However, the results were negatively affected by lower output in Daugavas hydropower plants, and it's mainly due to the fact that lower water inflow in river Daugava was lower, and the output decreased by some 19%. Additionally, here I want to mention that revenues and EBITDA in Q1 has improved in all operating segments, and now I will turn to performance of each operating segment. First about generation and supply. Generation and supply is the largest segment that makes some 58% of group EBITDA. Similarly to Latvenergo group results, generation and supply segment results were positively impacted by lower gas price, however negatively by lower water inflow. In Q1, the electricity generated in Riga CHPs was increased more than two times and reached 620 gigawatt hours, and this increase was fostered mainly by the gas price decline and also by lower temperature. Additionally, I want to mention that in the situation of limited import from abroad, Riga CHP was the main electricity generator that limited risk of electricity price increase in the region. Lower, however, if you look at thermal energy, then also lower air temperature was the reason why there was also larger amount of electricity generated in heat. In Q1, we have retained the leading electricity supplies position in Baltics with approximately one-third of the market. Our electricity sales increased by 1%. Additionally, we have managed to increase the client portfolio outside Latvia, and we have increased the client number of clients by 1,700 clients. And our sales activities in Lithuania and Estonia were mainly focused on small and medium-sized enterprises. No, let's take a look at distribution segment results, and distribution segment makes some 27% of group's EBITDA, and it is represented by Sadals Tīkls, which is a distribution system operator in Latvia. Distribution segment is fully regulated, and revenues of the segment depends on electricity consumption in Latvia and distribution service tariffs. In Q1, the revenues of segment increased by 6% and reached 79.66 million euros, and EBIT increased by 4%. Mainly, results of distribution were positively impacted by higher electricity consumption in Latvia and accordingly higher distributed service revenues. Investments in distribution assets were some 20.1 million euros. I would say that quite similar amount of investments was made in distribution also last year. The main purposes of these investments is to increase the quality of networks, network services, and also to minimize risk of network disorder. And therefore, it is pleasure to see that the trend of SIFI and SIDI indicator that are moving down over the last 5 years. Now let's move to third operating segment. Transmission assets makes 12% of group EBITDA, and it is represented by Latvijas Elektriskie Tīkli. This company owns transmission system assets and leases these assets to transmission system operator. Similarly to distribution segments, the transmission asset segment also is regulated operating segment. And in Q1, there was slight increase in revenues and EBITDA that was mainly impacted by gradual increase of regulatory asset base into the lease. In Q1, investments in transmission assets were some 3.8 million euros. The major ongoing investment projects are Kurzemes Ring and Estonia-Latvijas third interconnection project. As regards of our investments, in the first quarter we have invested a total of 34.7 million euros, which is by 9.9 million more than during the same period last year. The increase was mainly due to the progress of Daugavas hydropower unit reconstruction program. In Q1, we have invested 8.4 millions in reconstruction of Daugavas hydropower units. And at the same time, we see that the total investments in Daugavas hydropower plants has in this project has reached 60 million euros, and it is planned to reconstruct all remaining 11 units by 2022, and after reconstruction of these units, they will provide further 40 years of operations of hydropower units. The major ongoing transmission projects are Kurzemes Ring and Latvian and Estonian third interconnection project. Kurzemes Ring is aimed at increasing power supply in supply safety in Kurzemes region, and also to enable to use of Lithuanian Sweden interconnection Nordbolt. At the moment, first and second stage of the project is completed, and total investments in projects has reached 96 million euros, while the third stage of the project is scheduled for completion by 20, 19, and this project is co-financed by EU, covering 45% of construction costs. The third electricity transmission interconnection project between Estonia and Latvia is aimed at increasing transmission capacity between these two countries. Total project costs are estimated approximately 100 million euros. The project is scheduled for completion by the end of 2020. Also, this project is co-financed by EU, covering 65% of construction costs. As well, a large part of our investments in the first quarter, that is 58%, goes in the modernization of distribution assets, and with the main aim to improve the quality of network services in Latvia. Let's move to the next slide, debt and liquidity. The total Latvenergo group borrowings at the end of the March were 834 million euros. Debt repayment schedule is quite spread out over the following years. Borrowings include loans from international investment banks, commercial banks, as well as bonds. At the beginning of 2016, Moody's reconfirmed Latvenergo credit rating from Baa2 with a stable outlook, and also we have attracted sufficient liquidity reserves in order to implement the investment program and also to ensure debt repayment in due term. Before I turn to current issues, I would like to ask a question to the audience. Probably most of you have noticed that on 20th April we have published Latvenergo Group Sustainability and Annual Report. And Ieva, please launch our poll question to the audience. I would like to ask whether you find information in our Latvenergo sustainability report valuable, and please feel free to submit your feedback through the question box on the panel section. And the question is, do you find information in Latvenergo sustainability report valuable? And there are four options. Yes, no, to some extent, I haven't seen it. Meanwhile, I would like to let you know that on 5th May, Latvenergo Group audited the results were approved by shareholders meeting, and comparing to unaudited results, there are no significant changes in financial figures. Latvenergo Group revenue for year 2015 constitutes 929 million euros, while the profit was 85 million euros. Thank you for your feedback, now I will tell some words about our sustainability report. Since 2009, we published Latvenergo sustainability report in accordance with GRI guidelines that are most widely used guidelines for sustainability reporting. The latest sustainability report was published in accordance with the latest GRI guidelines G4, and G4 states that the focus should be on what matters and where it matters, which means that information disclosed in the report should be one that is most material for the company and its stakeholders. Therefore, we conducted an in-depth stakeholder engagement that was done last year in the form of seminar. And we believe that stakeholder engagement allowed us to understand what is important for our stakeholders and where we should put more focus. We believe that we have disclosed it also in our sustainability report mutually material information about the Latvenergo group. Now I would like to comment on distribution service tariff. Probably as you know, on 5th May, Public Utility Commission approved the electricity distribution system service tariff, which is expected to come into the force on 1st August 2016. And in order to make the change in the tariff, the detailed evaluation that lasted more than 1 year was performed by Sadalas Tīkls and Public Utility Commission, and the new balanced tariff foresees introduction of fixed fee to all customers, but at the same time there is a decrease in payment per actual consumption. For example, the new tariff model for household, instead of uniform tariff per kilowatt hour, will consist of two components. First one is a fixed fee, and this fixed fee depends from the capacity of power network connection, and second component is a payment per actual consumption. And the new balanced tariff helps to apply socially equal and responsible model, avoiding the situation where some electricity customers have to cover costs of zero consumption connections. And at the moment, there are approximately 120,000 connections in Latvia without active electricity consumption. And in the same time, there are also a large part of customers whose bills after the tariff change will remain unchanged or even decrease due to the fact that the actual component paid will be lower than existing. And we believe that the new tariff model would motivate also customers to optimize power connections, and would allow us to optimize distribution network and to minimize also investment needs. Next slide is about green bonds. On 14 April, green bonds in amount of 25 million euros were issued. Thus, we have completed the bond offering program in total amount of 100 million euros. In the latest issue, there was a high interest from investors. Demand was 5.8 times higher, ensuring spread of 120 base points. That is the same spread level as in the last issue, and the yield of the issue is 1.3%. The purchase orders were received from 21 investors, including asset management funds, insurance companies and banks in Latvia, Lithuania, Estonia, France, Austria and Finland. In the chart on the right side, you can see that majority of bonds were allocated to investors in Baltics, and more than half of investors are asset managers. Banks are approximately one third, and some 6% is allocated by insurance companies. As regards Latvenergo Green Bond Program, we are the first state-owned and investment-grade green bond issuer in the Eastern Europe. We have also received a second party opinion on green bond framework from Cicero, that our investment projects correspond to environmental and sustainability criteria, and also we have detailed information on the use of proceeds in our sustainability report of 2015. And by completing the green bond program, the total amount of bonds issued reached 205 million euros, that is approximately 25% of our borrowings. Before we start with questions and answers, let me summarize the main points of the presentation. So, our financial results have improved. Latvenergo Group's EBIT reached 100 million euros, and that is increased by 6%. And we have seen that EBIT increases in all operating segments. In addition to 75 million euro green bond issue last year, in April we have issued green bonds in value of 25 million euros. Thus we have completed our second bond offering program, and at the moment approximately 25% of borrowings are covered by bonds. That's it from my side, and let's now proceed with questions. Eva?
Mr. Baljons, thank you for the presentation. Yes, let's proceed with the questions in the order they were received. A reminder to those who haven't yet submitted their questions, you can do it in the questions section in the settings panel zone. So, the first question in line. Is Latvenergo capacity large enough to significantly increase sales in all three Baltic countries? Can Latvenergo produce enough electricity to offer it for a competitive price, not only in Latvia, but also in Estonia and Lithuania? Gunter?
Yes, thank you for the question. And here I want to mention that at the moment one third of our electricity is supplied to customers in Lithuania and Estonia. Thus we are competitive not only in Latvia but also in Estonia and Lithuania at the moment. However, regarding the use of our generation capacity, it is worth to mention that we optimize our electricity portfolio on everyday basis. Namely, we are generating the electricity in our plants when it's economically justified, and the is purchasing electricity in Nord Pool Power Exchange when the price is lower than our marginal costs. That's like our basic principle how we choose whether to generate electricity by ourselves or buying in Nord Pool Power Exchange. And definitely one thing that is good news for us is decrease of gas tariff, and that increases the competitiveness of our cogeneration plants. And we also believe that the fact that we own power plants, it also serves as an advantage and provides opportunity to attract customers in all three Baltic countries. Eva?
Thank you. The next one. Can you please share more information about the immovable properties that you are trying to sell? In March alone, you announced an auction offering four different properties. Gunther?
Yes, thank you for the question. And Rotenergo owns sites which are not used in economic active way, and therefore in order to rationally allocate our financial resources, these sites are auctioned, and the obtained funds are invested in other investment projects. Mainly these sites are previously used by our subsidiary Sadaus Tīkls, and Sadaus Tīkls, as a result of reconstruction and optimization of distribution network, actually they do not need these sites, and therefore we are going out with auctions. Ieva?
Thank you. You already briefly touched the gas tariff topic, and we have received a related question from a participant, which goes the following. And is there anything new in regards to obtaining gas transmission access from Latvijas Gāze? Is Litgas still ready to provide a test amount to Latvenergo, or has the deal been cancelled? Gunther?
Thank you for the question. At the moment there are no new things, and there is limited access to transmission capacity, and this question is in dispute in a regulator, and Latvijas Gāze has received the warning from regulator that access could be provided, but at the moment there is like no additional things that we could like comment on this issue.
Thank you. I'm sure you will keep us informed. By now, all questions are answered. A recording of the webinar will be available in Nasdaq Baltic YouTube channel and also in company's announcements. Mr. Balčiūns, thank you for the presentation and for your answers. Participants, thank you for joining. Till next time then.
Yes, thank you. Goodbye.